In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy and function of pec minor, pectoralis minor. This is pectoralis minor. Pectoralis minor, also known as pec minor. If there is pec minor, there should be pec major. However, pec minor and pec major are different. Pec major is shoulder joint muscle. However, pec minor is part of shoulder girdle muscle. Shoulder girdle means that attaches to scapula and somewhere in ribcage or thoracic spines. Okay, pec minor is shoulder girdle muscle. Let me explain origin and insertion first. Origin of pectoralis minor is right here. This is rib 3 through rib 5. Rib 3 through rib 5. That's it. Origin is right here. Very simple, right? Insertion is here. This tiny bony prominent of scapula. This is coracoid process. Yep, this part is scapula. This is anterior part of scapula. Do you remember definition of shoulder girdle muscle? That attaches to somewhere ribcage and scapula or spines. Yep, this is indeed shoulder girdle muscle. Origin, rib 3, 4, 5. Insertion, coracoid process. Now let me talk about function of pec minor. Alright, function of pec minor is very, very important. Look at origin and insertion and look at orientation of muscle fiber. It runs like kind of diagonal, right? Thus, when this muscle contracts, that brings scapula this way. So what kind of function is that? That is depression. Depression of scapula, that you lower down scapula. That is depression. Plus, that can do scapular abduction. Scapular abduction. Why is that? Because orientation of pec minor is kind of diagonal. That can bring scapula kind of this way. Okay? Then, that can bring scapula to abduction, outward. You know, this is posterior view. Abduction of scapula is this way. Imagine pec minor runs like this on anterior part. When this muscle contracts this way, now scapula is put kind of this way. Do you understand this orientation? Thus, pec minor does scapular abduction. It's a little bit hard to imagine, but you know, this is how it is. One more function, that is downward rotation. Downward rotation is this way, okay? Downward rotation is inferior angle of scapula kind of faces to thoracic spines. On the other hand, the other movement is upward rotation. This upward rotation is important. This upward rotation, downward rotation is important. So let me talk about this relationship later. Anyhow, function of pec minor is depression. Lower down scapula, scapula abduction, then downward rotation of scapula. That's about it. This function is very, very important. But before I'm going to talk about important relationship, let me explain relationship with nervous tissue. All right, you see nervous tissue. Again, this is pec minor. You see yellow bundles posterior to pec minor. This bundle of nerve is very important. This is brachial plexus. Brachial plexus. Plexus means bundle of nerves. Brachial means arm, right? So nervous tissues, nervous bundles in arm, upper extremity. Simple enough, right? Many nervous tissues emerge from brachial plexus. It becomes like axillary nerve, it becomes like median nerve, ulnar nerve, radial nerve. Many important nervous tissues emerge from brachial plexus. Such are important nervous tissues. Then, these nervous tissues runs posterior to peck minor. They are very, very close each other. Then what happens if peck minor gets tight? If there's adhesion, tightness, dysfunction right here, there is chance that tightness of peck minor may create impingement for brachial plexus. Again, do you remember where is these nervous tissues are going? It becomes like axillary nerve, shoulder joint. It can go to median nerve, it can go to ulnar nerve, elbow joint, forearm, fingers. So when this part gets impingement, this impingement may affect for numbness, pain, and dysfunction for whole part of upper extremity. This is very important. This kind of symptom is called thoracic outlet syndrome. Thoracic outlet syndrome. There are a few other causes of thoracic outlet syndrome, but peck minor can be one reason for this symptom. Nervous tissue and peck minor, very important relationship. Now let me explain why peck minor's downward rotation is important. All right, one of the functions of peck minor is downward rotation. Do you remember that? Downward rotation this way. Then what is the other way? This is upward rotation. Main upward rotation muscle of shoulder girdle is this one. This is serratus anterior. Serratus anterior. Why are these guys so important? Why are peck minor, serratus anterior, upward rotation, downward rotation important? Because these muscles, these movements are important for shoulder movement. When you want to move shoulder like 120 degrees, 180 degrees, your scapula needs to move together. Your scapula needs to move together with shoulder movement. You cannot ignore this relationship. Let's say if you want to do 180 degrees movement, 180 degrees movement, your shoulder moves 120, 120 out of 180. Then rest of 60 degrees is accomplished by scapula. Then this is 180, right? This ratio, 2-1, 2-1 is called scapulohumeral rhythm. Scapulohumeral rhythm. Simply, your scapula and shoulder needs to move together. Then here's the thing. When you do shoulder abduction, shoulder flexion, shoulder abduction or shoulder flexion, your scapula needs to go to upward rotation. If you move shoulder upward, abduction or flexion, your scapula needs to go to upward rotation. Again, what is function of peck minor? That is downward rotation. So if your peck minor is tight, your peck minor is restricted, it's hard to go to abduction or flexion. Why? Because your scapula needs to go to upward rotation. Peck minor is downward rotation. Thus, this dysfunction, this restriction may inhibit upward rotation of scapula. If upward rotation of scapula is inhibited, you can't move shoulder towards abduction nor flexion. Very, very important. So if you complain you have tight movement of scapula, maybe you focus on peck minor tightness. Most likely your peck minor got tension. Maybe your peck minor is tight. Again, peck minor function, one of the peck minor functions is downward rotation. Again, when you want to do shoulder abduction or shoulder flexion, your scapula needs to go to upward rotation. However, function of peck minor is downward rotation. This tightness inhibits upward rotation. Then this restriction affects for shoulder movement. Very important. Plus, if your serratus anterior doesn't work, it can't go to upward rotation, then it may restrict shoulder movement. That is why peck minor function and serratus anterior function is very important for shoulder movement. Then let me explain the other important thing. Now you understand why pec minor and serratus anterior are important. Let's say, if you bring your shoulder 180 degrees again, now what happens if your serratus doesn't work, if your serratus anterior is tight? In this 180 degrees position, scapula is in 60 degrees upward rotation, right? Do you remember that? Then, if serratus anterior is tight, it's hard to bring back your scapula to downward rotation. Do you remember? When you want to raise up shoulder, your serratus anterior needs to work. Your scapula needs to go to upward rotation. On the other hand, if you want to bring your shoulder down, now your pec minor needs to work. Your scapula needs to go to downward rotation. However, if your serratus anterior is tight, it's hard to go back to this way. Do you understand this relationship? Oh my gosh. That is why shoulder girdle muscles, pec minor, serratus anterior are very important for shoulder movement. Alright. In today's video, I explained anatomy and function of pectoralis minor. Plus, I explained very freaking important relationship with other muscles and shoulder movement. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.